We want to talk a little bit about no-till planter preparation. Still too many times I hear people say, gee, I don't know if my planter will handle no-till or not. And there are some issues to consider, but often if you look around in your part of the county, or certainly in your county, there's someone doing no-till and often with a planter not very far away that's maybe the same make and certainly same make and maybe the same model that you have also. So often it's a matter of adjustment, perhaps just a little bit of minor retooling, that type of thing. In terms of no-till operations, the planter really is the key. It is the one and really only chance that you've got to stir the soil or move the soil a little bit and get that seed established exactly the way you want it. And so treating that planter with respect and paying attention to some of the finer adjustments can really pay some big dividends, particularly in no-till operation. I always think there's three major things that a planter should do. Establish that seed at a uniform depth, get good seed to soil contact, and then get a reasonably uniform seed spacing along there. And if I had to rank order them, I probably would even perhaps do it in that order. But those first two things, depth and seed soil contact, can be particularly important in terms of seed manipulation and just soil changes and no-till. And so we're going to spend a little time talking about some of those issues that way. One of the first things that you need to consider really before you start looking at the row units themselves is making sure that planter is leveled up fairly well. I know it sounds a little bit trite, but you've got a closing system, maybe a set of closing wheels on the rear of the row units. Often you have something in front of the row unit, whether that be a row cleaner, set of row cleaners, or maybe a coulter, or perhaps both. You're going to have real difficulty getting the amount of pressure and really the depth adjustments on that correct if you don't have that planter pretty well leveled up. So there's a couple of areas to check, both the fore and aft, or front and back leveling, and also the side to side. In terms of that front to back leveling, the key for most pull type planters is usually right up here at the drawbar hitch on the tractor. Now on this particular planter, we've got a clevis hitch on that drawbar. And you see the adjustment holes there, and those are there for a purpose so that you can get that planter pretty well leveled up. Today we've got our planter parked in the farm lot here, and so we're on a little bit of slope, and so we're never going to get a true level adjustment here at the moment in the lot. But once you get to the field, fine-tuning that, making sure that you've got that balance. In addition, you need side-to-side adjustment here too, and typically that has to do with the frame transport tires or wheels on the planter. Again, it sounds kind of trite here, but those tires all need to be inflated appropriately for the load they're carrying and uniformly. If you've got a low tire, why, that's going to give you some problems in terms of the depth of operation or how you're going to get those row units adjustment. And once in a while, somebody gets in a hurry, and maybe when they replace a tire, they don't pay close enough attention to what they're putting on there, and so it's a much more rare circumstance, but it can happen somebody gets the wrong tire size on too. And again, the whole key here is leveling up the planter.